So you got the X-Men, you got the Avengers, you got the Fantastic Four, you got the Guardians of the Galaxy. There's another team of Marvel superheroes that needs some more attention though, and they are the Inhumans. Shout Factory's just put out the Marvel Knights version of the Inhumans motion comic. This is based off a 12-issue run by Paul Jenkins, Eisner Award-winning run by Paul Jenkins, and it's really pretty entertaining to watch. The story centers on the island kingdom of Adalan. It's very secluded, and it's inhabited by the Inhumans, a race of super beings who like to keep to themselves. When humans begin to attack Adalan, wanting to pillage their technology, the leader of the Inhumans, Black Bolt, must decide whether to engage in combat or take a wait-and-see approach. The story is fantastic. Paul Jenkins has written this wonderful piece that gives you an inside look at the Inhumans. We learn about how they become mutants. It's not like the X-Men where you're just born with a mutation. Here, you actually decide to become mutated. It's a rite of passage that all teenagers must go through. When they choose to take on their mutation, they step into these tubes and it's filled with something called the Terrigen Mists. And these mists will accelerate their DNA and unlock their hidden potential. You don't know if you're going to be turned into a big rock man or a scaly girl with wings, or you're just going to have really long fingers. It's an excellent metaphor, and in some ways works better than the metaphors that we've seen in the X-Men comics of coming of age and learning what it is to become an adult and accepting those things about yourself that some might see as negatives and turning them into positives.
It's more than we could have hoped for. Our daughter, a flyer.
You look big.
Along the way, we meet Black Bolt's evil brother who tries to orchestrate the overthrow of the government. And we learn a lot about Black Bolt. He's an amazing character. His main power, if he says even the slightest thing, if he sneezes, if he whispers, it'll create a wave of devastation. So in a lot of ways, he's one of the most powerful beings on the planet, but he can't use his power unless he's prepared for total devastation, which turns him into this really, really interesting figure when he makes some really hard decisions, decisions that involve not fighting back. When the humans are trying to invade their land, that's where we get a lot of the drama. The story isn't so much action-based. There's a lot of action that happens in it, but it's much more about political intrigue, government overthrows, and class systems. It transcends a hokey comic book story and turns into something that has a lot of depth and insight to the human nature. That story is enhanced by Jay Lee's amazing artwork. He's able to really capture the essence of these characters in such a way that it's just beautiful to look at. Unfortunately, the artwork doesn't really lend itself to animation. Sometimes it just looks clunky, especially when the characters are trying to talk or they have any kind of facial expressions that need to change.
It's my husband, Marista. Sometimes I wonder at the weight of his responsibility.
It looks a little bit clunky at times. I never felt like I was taken out of the story. And after a couple minutes, you really get used to the animation style, but it's not exactly on par with traditional animation. This definitely feels like it's been jerry-rigged in a lot of ways to turn it into a motion comic. I can't recommend this to everybody. I think if you're a comic connoisseur who's already read the 12 issues of the Inhumans that this is based on, or you picked up the trade version of it, I don't think you're going to get much out of this. But if you're someone like me who missed the initial run of the Inhumans, or at least this section of the Inhumans, and this is your first exposure to it, it's very enjoyable, and I really dug it. I feel like the disc could be improved, though. Instead of having each of the 12 chapters put onto the disc individually, I would have loved to have seen a super cut of all of these episodes together. Each one runs 12 minutes, and of those 12 minutes, two of those minutes are credits and the opening sequence, which gets a little annoying if you're trying to watch each of these back to back. You gotta sit through credits and the opening sequence over and over and over again. It's just a little annoying. No real special features on this, with the exception of a documentary featuring Joe Quesada and Paul Jenkins talking about their experiences working with the Inhumans and why they chose to animate this story in particular. So overall, I liked this version of the Inhumans very much. I don't think it's for everybody. I think if you're a hardcore comic fan, you're not gonna get much new out of this, but if you've never been exposed to the Inhumans before, this isn't a bad place to start. But those are just my thoughts. You can leave your comments below and keep checking in with AintItCool.com for more news and reviews. I'm John Airy.